He's literally the man that needs no introduction. What I'm trying to say is not that he's just popular, but he's the man who, when you hear, you will know who he is. He's an expert. He's got a vast amount of experience. And all of this reflects in every statement he makes. Not to say he's a guarded speaker. He's an excellent speaker, an amazing communicator, and one of the most widely acknowledged teachers of international law that you'll find in the country. Dr. T.R. Subramania graduated with majoring in history. He studied his law. He's taught in the University College of Law at Harvard. Subsequently went on to do his PhD from Jawaharlal Nehru University. He's held a number of key positions throughout his work life. You know, he's been the legal advisor to the Kingdom of Bahrain. He's been the former dean, the former registrar evaluation of Bangalore University. Eventually, he went on to be the vice chancellor of the Karnataka State Law University. He also held the chair for policy and public governance in the National University of Juridical Sciences in Kolkata. But all these achievements is not what makes the man. The Dr. Subramania that we've seen here at CMR University School of Legal Studies is someone who is well known amongst all our staff and students for his strong work ethic. I mean, we walk by his chamber every day. His doors are always open, by the way. I mean, we see him preparing, you know. Sometimes he ends up preparing for an entire day to deliver a small lecture to maybe even an undergraduate batch of students. And this, you know, on a subject that he's taught for a lifetime. More than his work ethic, what we've all come to admire is his commitment to everything that he does. Once he begins something, he doesn't stop, and he doesn't let us stop either. In fact, the video that you are about to see next, with, you know, where he's trying to explain what is the content of this course, you know, is a testament to his commitment. You know, we started shooting the video, and midway it started raining heavily, and you know, raindrops started spattering on his back and on his sleeve, but the man just wouldn't stop. He said what he had to say, and he finished shooting the video, and only then would he come back into shelter. That's Dr. T.R. Subramania for you. And what is he teaching? He's going to be teaching the subject in which we all believe he's an expert: international law. We've decided to make this, or rather call this as, a refresher course on international law, because what we intend to do is to refresh your knowledge, to rejuvenate you with respect to your, you know, to whatever you know on international law. And we've carefully selected topics which, as I said, Dr. Subramania will go on to explain a little later, but then we've chosen these topics extremely carefully so as to encompass as much of international law as possible. Well, who is this course for? This is a course that can be done not only by law students, not just students of international law, but also teachers of international law. By professionals, by people who are interested in international law, anybody, really. You know, we are not looking at any eligibility criteria here, but then all of you are most welcome to register for the course. But most importantly, remember, it's a course that's being taught by one of the masters, and that makes it no less than a master class. So what are you waiting for? Just go ahead, click the register button. We are waiting here to teach you international law. Thank you.
The very purpose of international law and its study is growing in the last 50-60 years. It is growing for the simple reason a vast subjects like international trade, aviation, science and technology, nuclear science, all of them have become part of international law. For a student of law, a knowledge of international law is very much essential. Without it, his course is incomplete. That is the reason we have given a particular course on studies in international law, covering major areas of the subject, wherein sources equally stand a prominent place. Then the relationship between international law and municipal law is very much essential for a student of law in knowing issues relating to state responsibility. Simultaneously, the dwindling character of the state sovereignty, which is also very important. And the student of international law should also know the basic rights and duties of states. Then issues pertaining to jurisdiction, how jurisdiction is being exercised, especially when our nationals go and work abroad in a foreign country, what type of jurisdiction is being exercised over corporations. These are matters which are relevant for today, especially in the area of information technology. There are other chapters as well which are very important. A student of international law is supposed to know something relating to the Charter of the United Nations. When the United Nations was formed, there were only 5 permanent members, and today the very concept is getting changed. It is getting changed for the simple reason those permanent members are no longer hold sway, nor they are in a position to stabilize in the maintenance of international peace and security. The International Court of Justice and its role is also an important area, wherein it has delivered wonderful judgments, and these judgments are tendered by way of what we call as between states in a case, and by way of advisory opinions. And these judgments have helped us for the growth of international law. It has tried to refine rules of international law. It has helped us to live as good citizen society, and the study of international law is made for all these objectives and purposes. Thank you.